could carry that kind of weight. It was my turn till I made.
Happy World Wish Day to the Make-A-Wish Foundation. Today they're celebrating 40 years of granting wishes to kids that are so deserving. And due to the pandemic, more wishes are waiting than ever before. And if that's you, I encourage you to stay positive and know that you're inspiring so many people around you. I can't wait to see your dreams and your wishes come true. If you want to help the Make-A-Wish Foundation grant more wishes, head over to sf.wish.org.
Hey TVU, Scott Reese has the story of this warrior star making a child's dream come true.
Brandon Kelman was a beautiful, healthy baby boy for about 6 weeks.
He started having these sort of quirky movements, these sort of reflexes that didn't seem quite right. We were told, oh, it's just the reflex, babies do that, not a big deal. Within a week's time, they escalated to a point where it was clear there was something going on.
What was going on were infantile spasms, the most catastrophic seizures an infant can have.
The worst thing for any parent is to watch your offspring suffer and know that you can't do anything about it.
The only solution at the time seemed to be what's called a hemispherectomy, basically removing half of his brain.
They can't go in and perform a brain surgery on a four-month-old because it's not gonna go so well. So they wanted him to get stronger. So they gave him this medicine to slow the seizures down. That's all it was supposed to do, slow it down. And I have these doctors that to this day are scratching their head whenever we go back for a yearly because not only did it slow him down, it stopped them.
We got extremely lucky. However, because of the malformation, he developed cognitive, physical delays. So his entire life, he struggled.
Such was the backdrop for Brandon's childhood. But the Kelman family persevered. In time, the kid who was not expected to walk or talk did both, and so much more.
To watch him keep developing with the never say never attitude, it has inspired the heck out of myself, my kids, my neighborhood. People are amazed at where he has come from, where he should be and where he is now.
Sports were not a part of Brandon's life as a small child. Couldn't play them, didn't watch them. That is until his younger brother, Jack, showed him a video from the internet.
Curry, when he started to make these unbelievable half-court shots.
Curry flings it the other way, and he got it!
I found the video and I showed Brandon, and he looked at it, and just I could see his eyes just glow up the second he saw the video. And ever since then, he's tracked every single basketball game that Steph Curry plays. He knows every single player on the Warriors.
Steph Curry!
Cognitively, we didn't even think he was capable of understanding and comprehending. I was blown away.
You might say Curry became a healthy obsession. And then something even more amazing happened. That obsession gave way to emulation.
One day he came to me after watching Steph and he said, I want to learn how to shoot baskets. This was a child that I couldn't get to go outside and play with my other kids. Brandon couldn't catch, his balance was off.
We bought him a basketball, he would play and we would watch him with his left hand and it was really difficult and the ball would bounce and it would get away from him.
It wasn't really easy for me, so.
He just kept practicing and practicing and practicing, and all of a sudden my kid was playing basketball.
I dribble the ball. I can't dribble with two hands, but I try. I want to be just like Steph Curry and an NBA player.
My kid was enjoying a sport and living a life as normal as a kid can, being 14 years of age, playing basketball outside with his brothers. I would have never dreamed in a million years, and we were told it would never be possible.
Basketball and Curry became Brandon's world. But in that world, unlike the one most of us live in, a boy's idol is readily accessible.
He said to me, Mom, my only wish is to meet Steph Curry. Might as well tell me I want to meet Barack Obama. I went on this mission to have him meet his hero. Long story short, I was connected to the Warriors, and here we are.
Look how tall he is.
It's huge.
Nice to meet you. How you doing?
Good.
All right, where do you want to shoot from?
Ooh.
I'm going to play defense one time. You're shooting from right there? Get in there.
Ooh.
There it is right there.
This was kind of your dream, right?
It came true, and I saw him. I thought I could never gonna see him, but I saw him.
Yeah, you played a little one-on-one. Now, who won?
I don't know. Maybe me or I think.
I saw you make more shots than he did.
For a kid like Brandon to just be able to get out and play and overcome a lot of obstacles, that means a lot. So it just gives me more motivation to keep doing what I'm doing.
Keep fighting, keep doing it. Nobody can tell you can't do anything.
I can't believe I'm having an out-of-body experience watching my kid out there actually throw the ball with Steph Curry and make it. I mean, he had a few great shots. It just gives him that sense that he can be normal. The self-confidence he gained today is priceless to me, absolutely priceless.
It restores my faith in humanity to be able to give my child a gift that he will have the rest of his life and he will feel like he is somebody. I just want to say thank you, and it's just, it's moving, very moving.
Yeah, happy?
I think the best day ever for me.
Wow, to see him smile and just to go out there, and Steph Curry to be so gracious to do that and see him throwing, and it's amazing. What a great story.
I know. Were you getting choked up? Because I was. Well,
yes, it's just such a good feeling.
It's a great story.
Yeah.
Remember me.
what you came for. This is the moment magic was made for.
Today, where we're granting 6 life-changing wishes to kids with critical illnesses. The FaZe Clan guys are here and they're downstairs right now playing video games with the kids, and they're having a pizza party, and we even have an amazing surprise for them later today with our friends from GameStop, where they'll be able to go with the FaZe Clan members and they'll be able to go ahead and do some quick shopping at GameStop. We are so happy that FaZe Clan donated their time today to grant these wishes to these 6 amazing kids from across the nation and even 1 kid from the Netherlands. Thanks again, FaZe Clan, for doing this for us and making these kids' wishes come true.
What's up, man? How are you doing?
What's your name?
Hi, how are you?
Nice to meet you.
Hi, how's it going? What's up, guys? How we doing?
There you go, man.
What's your name again?
Savion.
Nice to meet you.
I brought some of my merch.
Hi!
I should bring you in.
I have a gun, y'all.
The default damage.
How are we doing, man?
Fine.
Are you guys hungry at all? We got plenty of pizza.
Yeah. I'm calling it! Show me the FaZe logo!
Come on!
I want to see it!
So,
yeah, we have 2 more chances over here.
I was playing Fortnite the other day, and I realized that your trophy is in the middle.
Oh yeah, it's in creative. It's in creative. That's what Lucas pointed out last video. He's like,
yo, he's just in the game, dude. He's just there.
I know, it's pretty dope.
How's the pizza? 10 out of 10.
Alright, let me know, who is your favorite FaZe member?
Rug or Sisters of Jarvis. They're nice. Their videos are fun to watch.
You know, you're going to be in the next video.
Yeah.
So you'll be able to see yourself next time.
Yeah. When I was in the hospital, I watched a lot of videos because there was a lot of crying children because they're hurt. So I did my headset on and watched videos so I can't hear anything around me.
Did that help you through a lot of your hard
time? And when I'm going to the operation, then I watched videos to calm down a little bit.
What? On an 11-hour flight, you didn't sleep at all.
I'm gonna phase out going.
I don't know how to do it.
Okay, so take this finger, like do a peace sign, and take this finger and just go down. go all the way down with that. And then take your thumb and put it on there. Yep, like that. So it should look like an F. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There it is.
There it is. That's how you do it.
Who are you?
I'm Amber. I'm Xavion's mom.
I'm Daryl. I'm Xavion's dad.
And we really enjoy being here. This experience has been great for our son.
Yeah. At first, I was telling a couple guys earlier that he was just so mellow and calm, but like when we rolled up and he was like, oh, that's the, what's the house called?
The Phase House.
Yeah, the Phase House and the club.
The Cloud House, right?
Cloud House. Yeah, he saw Cloud just went jumping up and down, and who was the Phase car? And
he was really excited, and that made me happy after dealing with everything that we've been through.
And you know, you guys, you know, were a big help to him, and you know, doing his recovery and everything. Like, I didn't understand what he was doing at the time, but I see now like the impact that it had on him.
Yeah, so we're taking the Make-A-Wish kids. We're gonna show them a house tour real quick. We're gonna show them the rooftop up here, then we're gonna go over to the Cloud House, show them that rooftop. And just a little special surprise once we're done touring the house. But we'll talk about that later. What do you think of the view though? Rated out of 10. Give us your...
This is like a 14.
It's a 14, he said.
You can see everything.
The Hollywood sign.
The Hollywood sign is right around the corner. We're not gonna be able to see it from here, but we got our signed by the pool. Very nice. I was just swimming in here yesterday. It's so nice out here. It's so nice.
And what's your name?
Esteban.
And how old are you?
17.
So who's your favorite Faith member?
Probably Banks.
Banks?
Banks, yeah.
Oh, look who it is right now. Your favorite Faith member right there. So how long have you been watching Faith videos?
Probably since like Ilkem, like back in the day, yeah. They represent, like for me, they've done so much for me. Like they helped me get through when I was hospitalized. So it's pretty cool that they helped me get through everything. Thank you for everything like you've done for me, and I'm pretty sure you've done for others. I feel like you guys like save people's lives. Like if they're going through depression, anxiety, no matter what, like you guys can like, your videos help people like go through anything.
The Phase House, we all gave him a tour of the fourth floor. It was pretty awesome. But now we're gonna go over to the Cloud House, show him what's up. I wanna hit the orange Justin camera.
I've been watching Phase since the New York House for a long time. I picked them because, you know, I thought it seemed right, you know, going from chemotherapy, getting out of it, and the effects it would have on me, you know, I would watch the videos. You know, it'd bring me up and I'd start grinding, you know, Call of Duty, Halo, whatever game that was out at the moment. But, you know, it's something breathtaking, you know. Something I never thought would happen, man. I mean, I'm very thankful for the Phase Clan and Make-A-Wish for everything. And it means a lot to me.
Oh, oh, look at that. He's, oh, oh.
Hey, hey.
Oh,
about this guy
over here, too. Hold it up. Hold it up. Oh, yeah. Good.
The mouth.
Yo, look at that.
What's up, man?
You got bills?
Yo, y'all should just sign me already. I got my jersey.
He's noted on the sticks. We just left the Cloud House. We took a couple vans here. We got all the kids. And we're actually going to take a stop at GameStop real quick. And we got a couple surprises for them. They're going to go on a little shopping spree, actually. There's going to be goodie bags over here. And I think there's a $500 gift card. 500 bucks. So we're just going to walk around. Yeah, they're going to have bags and a gift card. And there's some more goodies and stuff in the bag. But once they get that gift card, they're gonna be so high. A couple kids were saying, I want a scuff controller, I want this controller.
We got them.
Well, don't worry, now we got them. Their names on all the boxes. Again, shout out GameStop. All right, this is gonna be really awesome. We did this last time with the Make-A-Wish kids. They loved it, so they're definitely gonna love it this time too. I'm excited, bro, I'm so excited. Yeah, we're just gonna go around with you. We're just gonna go a little shopping spree real quick. Let's run it up, baby. You don't have to spend it all right now, but you can if you want.
Oh man, hold on.
Look at him.
Which one of y'all like Devin Booker?
Hey. Hey, I'm here for a Make-A-Wish Foundation, bro. Can you say hi to a couple of kids real quick?
Hi.
You know you play with my favorite player.
He wants to be in the NBA just like you when he gets older, bro.
The PS4 VR headset. He said his friend's got a VR headset he wants to play. And then he also hooked up his brother with a new headset.
He's gonna get hooking up
a controller. And then I got a gift card.
I got $10. I got 10 of these.
What are you gonna buy?
V-Bucks on Fortnite.
This is the man, alright? He gets $500 to spend at GameStop. And the first thing he says, he looks over to his brother and he goes, "I'm buying you a PlayStation."
I was gonna get him the
That is the kind of brother you wanna have.
Let me tell you about this guy. First, he's the first kid I met today. And I'm like, wow, this kid's so cool. He's telling me, like, yeah, I play Modern Warfare, I'm grinding, blah, blah, blah. I make music too. Look at these beats I made. And I'm like, wow, Xavion, really cool kid. I'm having a great time. Hold on, Xavion. Then all of a sudden, he just decides to flip a switch and start trash talking. And then for hours, look at him. Look at this guy making short jokes. Come on, stand up straight. I might be older, but how are you gonna make, that's like, how are you gonna make a short joke if you're 19?
Bro, I'm 15 and I'm almost older than, and I'm almost taller than him.
Yeah, well you just stuttered like a dap right there, so I don't wanna hear it. He's like, can you FaceTime a dap? Not you, someone else asked. I FaceTime a dap, the first thing he says is, I love it. This guy's a roast master, bro, he keeps coming for me. All right, that is the end of our awesome day here with our friends from Make-A-Wish. Thank you to Make-A-Wish and GameStop. They gave them an awesome gift as well. We had a great time with them at the FaZe house. And these guys, wait, I actually have a question. Who here is going to be in FaZe, by the way, one day?
Me?
Yeah.
Okay, some of them, they're telling me they're going to see, I'm going to see them in FaZe soon, so we'll see. He beat Jarvis, I guess, in a one. Thank you guys for using your wish to come meet us. And I don't know, again. I don't know if we're cool that cool, but they that was one thing they just wanted to do, and we had a great time. So thank you guys.
It was amazing.
Meet
day,
the FaZe fans. Thank you, Make-A-Wish, GameStop, everybody, and their awesome family.
Good rest of your trip.
Hey, Make-A-Wishers.
What's up?
Hey, Make-A-Wish kids!
I just want to send a message out to you guys.
Sending lots of love.
I know the world is going through
tough times right now.
Things are a bit confusing.
And that social distancing has been hard.
It's tough not being able to see one another.
I can only imagine how many of your wishes have been canceled or postponed.
But don't let that stop you from making wishes.
Don't let anyone take that away from you. Not a person, definitely not a virus.
We just have to keep our heads up.
We have to be strong in order to win battles.
Those in the Make-A-Wish Foundation are some of the strongest souls in the world.
You guys are the true examples of bravery.
And you guys are honestly way stronger than this Roblox YouTuber. Yeah, guys.
You shine so bright and bring so much positivity to everyone around you. So continue being the strong and beautiful you.
You cannot make a beautiful rainbow without a little bit of rain.
We are coming together as one to fight this.
And we'll become one big family.
And if we can make it through this, which I know we all can, then we can make it through anything.
This crazy time will pass.
And when it does, we're gonna get back to granting those wishes.
And I pray for every single one of your wishes to come true.
We are here for you.
Guys, we're rooting for you.
I know what's happening isn't ideal.
But that doesn't mean we should lose hope.
We heard. Yeah, there's hope.
Remember, you are loved, supported, and you have your family and friends behind you who can always seek support from.
Never give up.
And never stop wishing.
Soon all of our wishes are going to come true, okay?
Stay positive, and most importantly,
believe yourself.
The Roblox community is one of
love and support.
And we will all work together
to help each other through it.
We all love you very much. Me and Roblox and all the other developers.
And we hope this message makes you smile.
We're thinking about you guys.
I hope I get the chance to talk to more of you soon.
Hopefully you guys are doing okay and can look forward to the future.
Hang in there.
You are not alone in this fight.
We're with you.
We will all
get through this
difficult times
together.
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 This is Builderman. I wanted to send you this message to let you know that I'm thinking of you during these times. Don't give up hope and don't stop making those wishes. You are all incredibly strong and inspiring to me and to many others around the world. The virus will pass, and we'll get back to granting your wishes. From everyone here at Roblox and across our community, we are thinking of you.
Much love.
We're here for you,
So keep wishing.
Keep hoping.
Keep smiling.
Don't stop.
Love you guys.
Bye.